Got a thing for Chanel vintage that dropped before she could speak English. Do you love me and love seeking attention? I mean, which one is it? You keep calling me a twin, but twins ain't this different. Mentally, I'm already.
Hey, y'all. Okay, so I don't know. Like, I wanted to make a video today, and it's kind of going to be like about something like kind of serious. So I don't know. Like, I always know I may make like goofy videos, but today, like, I'm actually going to make. Talk about something like really serious. So a lot of people don't know that, like, with my situation, that there are like a lot of side effects. I know before, like, I talked about the depression, the anxiety and stuff like that, but like one thing that I suffer from is like I'm like kind of like insecure, just because like I know how much I've changed. Like, my appearance wise, there was a time where, like, because of like my surgery, I had to cut off my hair, so I had a fade. And like, I love my fade, don't get me wrong, but like looking in the mirror and actually seeing myself, like, I don't know, like, I couldn't look in a mirror for like a long time because I just like wasn't used to myself looking like that. And like, even now, like, it's hard because like a lot of people, like, if I talk to people from like my past that haven't seen me in a while, they're just like, tell me like, oh, you look so different, or oh, you're so little. Like, I literally have days where I just don't feel comfortable in my skin, like, at all. Like, I know that I'm not like an ugly person, but like I do know that like I don't look the same either. And it's hard too for me because like I have all like my little battle, I call them battle wounds. So like really this one, like on my neck, this is like my main one, because I feel like a lot of people, like when they see me, they don't look at my face. I feel like they just look straight at my neck and they see this big scar on my neck. Like, I really feel like that is something, like, it's a good thing, like I like it, but I just don't feel comfortable with it. Like, I've always since I've had my surgery, I've never stopped like trying to figure out like how can I get rid of this scar. And like I've used like this oil to help with it, but like I guess the way that my neck, it was cut, I don't know, like, I don't think it'll ever go away unless I did like a cosmetic surgery, but I'm not gonna do that. Like, I'm like terrified of the hospital, so it's not that serious to get rid of for me to be having surgery. But one thing that like I learned in my yoga class, like it was just like so hard, like listening and talking to the other people. We were like discussing like things, how we feel like people with brain tumors, we kind of feel like we're kind of like in our own little world. So like other people that don't have brain tumors or brain injuries, they don't like necessarily understand the things that we go through and like how we feel about things. And so we had like a long talk about that, and I feel like that too, like people that don't have a brain injury, like they don't understand. Like, a lot of times I get really frustrated with like my mom, because I feel like my mom, like, she doesn't understand like fully. Like, I feel like sometimes she thinks just because like she stayed with me at the hospital like every day, she knows like everything and like how I feel and like the things that I need to do to take care of my body and like all of this, like dealing with my health. But like, it's a lot of things that like my mom doesn't know about my health, and like she doesn't understand. Like, there's a lot of different things that I have to take into consideration like every day when I just go about my daily activities. Like, I can't just like wake up and like just start my day and not eat. Like, I have to eat before I get my day started. I can't just have like cereal or like a Pop-Tart. Like, I have to have like a real meal, like some, like definitely something like with bread. Like, I have to have like a full breakfast for me to get my day started, or else like I get lightheaded. Like, it just becomes like this long process. So like, I just feel like she doesn't understand, and it's a lot of people, like, they don't get it, and it's like hard, and it gets frustrating when you try to like explain that all the time. But like, the main reason I wanted to make this video today was just because like I've been having like going through like a lot of like personal things, like me and the last person that I was with, we separated or whatever, and it's definitely like it's hard. It's been really hard not having that person in my life anymore. And like, I don't know, I just want to tell people, like, if you have a friend that's like going through something, like something traumatic, and then going through like a big breakup, like, just let them be. Like, don't be so pushy. Like, I feel like I have a lot of people in my life that are really pushy, because they're just like, I guess, kind of like not tired of seeing me sad, but just they just want me to be like in a better place because of like everything that I've been through, and then like going through something like so traumatic, like what I've been through, and then like a breakup. So I feel like they just want like, they want like something different for me. But in the same breath, like, I don't like to be pushed. I don't like for people to kind of like try to force me to do something that I don't want to do. And especially like right now, like, I feel like the time that I'm taking to make myself better, like, I need this time for me to be good. Like, I don't want to go on in life with all this stuff like just bottled up, and then like me be angry and upset. Like, I'm like learning to be at peace with things. I'm learning like not to just flip out when I'm upset. Like, I just want to do this like self-healing. And I feel like a lot of people, they don't understand. They just want, like, they just think that things are gonna just go back are just gonna change like that. And I don't know, like, I just feel like if you have a friend, just let them heal. Like, whenever they're ready to do things, like go out. Like me, I'm like so, I guess, kind of shell-shocked from like everything. So like, I don't even like really like going in public that much. Like, I'll go, but I really don't like it because, like, I don't like people staring at me. Like, going out to dinner, like, even though I can eat now, I don't like going out to eat because I don't like people looking at me, because I eat, like, really slow. Like, I don't know. Like, I'm really insecure about a lot of things. But, like, I try. Like, I'll push myself. Sometimes I'll just do it anyway, just for the simple fact that because I know I need to, like, do, like, live my new normal life. So I'll like push myself, but I really don't like it. I really just kind of like stick to myself, and like even like dating wise, like me, I'm actually, in all honesty, I'm pretty much terrified to like date. Even like, I don't know, like I'm just terrified. Even if it's just talking to somebody, like, I'm so scared to even just to let somebody get close to me. Like, I don't want to explain like my health situation. I don't want to have to like do any of that. So, because like, I'm scared because I just feel like they're going to judge me, and like on some, no, like, this is too much baggage. Like, I can't deal with this. Like, I just, I don't know. I just feel like I can't do it. Like, in all honesty, like, in my mind, all hope that I ever had for a relationship or anything, like, I feel like all that is, like, going out the window. And I don't know, like, I don't know if it's, like, because, like, my tumor or what, but, like, I'm just, like, so, like, I'm secure, like, about how I look. Like, I know that I'm pretty, and I know that, like, I'm a nice person or whatever, but I still, like, feel insecure just because, like, of what I've gone through, like, my health, and, like I said, some of my, like, little, like, battle scars or whatever you could call them. So I just feel like that can be a setback for me sometimes, and, like, those things shouldn't matter, because if, like, somebody really wants to talk to you and care about you, like, none of those things should matter, and I get that. But it's just something that I like, kind of deal with. I have issues with. And I don't know. I just kind of, like, wanted to talk about it because it was on my mind, like, real heavy. And I was going to actually make this video, like, tomorrow. But I was like, no, I'm going to just make it right now because, like, I just kept thinking about it. But I don't know. So, like, if you guys know somebody or maybe if it's somebody that's watching this video, like, I feel like if you feel that way, like, don't feel bad. A lot of times, like, when I get down, I, like, write, and it really helps me, or I listen to music. But I feel like self-love is everything, and I'm learning that a lot. Like, I've really been learning that, like, especially, like, when people try to push me to do stuff that I want to do. And I, like, literally stand up for myself and be like, nah, we're not doing this. Like, I feel like me putting myself first is, like, showing me that I love myself more than I love somebody or something, you know? So, like, it's definitely okay to put yourself first. I don't know. I'm going to make another video in a couple of days because something good is going to happen. So I'm going to make another video. If you have any other questions, comment, like, subscribe, and I'll see you guys in a couple of days.
Thank for Chanel Vintage that dropped before she could speak English. Do you love me and love seeking attention? I mean, which one is it?